All right, last chance, delegates. If you're not connected to the internet, please come and see me. We will be running a test vote here shortly. But if you're not connected to the internet now, please come and see me at the sound booth. And last helpful request to our guests and supporters, if you are able to disable your Wi-Fi on your phone temporarily while you're in this building, it will be greatly helpful to us. Thank you very much.
Delegates, welcome to the final and arguably most important session of the 2023 Oregon FFA State Convention. I hope you are as excited as we are to begin the election of the 2023-2024 Oregon FFA State Officer Team. We will work our way through elections in this order. First, the nominating committee chair will announce the slate of the top 10 candidates. We will follow the election speeches from the 10th at-large candidate to the candidate slated for president. Following speeches, the election process will commence, where we will take nominations for specific offices from the floor. I'd like to now explain specifically the election process and how a candidate will be elected. Those slated at the office of president do not need to be nominated. I will take nominations from any official delegate from the list of candidates slated secretary to at-large. I will close nominations when there are no more nominations to be made or if the delegate floor ceases to nominate anyone further. We will then proceed to vote on the office of president, each delegate receiving one vote. A candidate must receive a majority of the votes to be elected. If there is no majority, a runoff will be declared and we will continue voting until a majority is reached. This process will continue until there is a candidate who has received a majority of the votes. In order to be recognized by the chair to nominate a candidate, a delegate must raise their chapter sign and wait for the microphone and then start saying their first and last name, followed by their chapter, and ending with the name of the candidate they would like to nominate. We, as a state association, cannot stress to you the importance and honor that goes along with the title of delegates here at convention. You have been chosen to vote on issues and matters of business dealing with our state association's future. As we elect the next six individuals who will be representing our state this year, please take this job seriously as we go throughout this morning's session. To start things off, I have the pleasure of introducing a member who has been striving to reach for decisions with his committee throughout convention as your nominating committee chair. Please help me welcome to the podium Fred Sutherland of the Newburgh FFA chapter in the Lower Willamette District.
Good morning, delegates. My name is Fred Sutherland from the Newburgh FFA chapter in the Lower Willamette FFA District, and I've had the pleasure of serving as the 2023 Oregon FFA nominating committee chairman. And on behalf of the committee, I am excited to announce to you the slate of officers for the 2023 to 2024 Oregon FFA state officer team. But first, I would like to introduce my committee, who over the past 3 days have put in countless hours interviewing and observing our candidates. From the Blue Mountain District, Kayla Cheney from McLaughlin. From the Capital District, Ryan Davis from Jefferson. From the Eastern Oregon District, Maggie Stanbro from Pine Eagle. From the Mount Hood District, Marie Mason from Malala. From the Northwest District, Jenna Russell from Astoria. From Snake River, Paige Edson from Ontario. From the Southern Oregon District, Wyatt Stillwagner from Rogue River. From the Umpqua District, Kaylee Chandler from Days Creek. And from the Upper Willamette District, Ashley Gibbs from Santa Ana Christian. And now, the time you've been waiting for. Slated at president in alphabetical order by first name, from Bend, J.L. Cruikshank. And from Hermiston, Kylie Temple. Slated at secretary, from Lost River, Alicia Venegas. Slated at treasurer, from Elkton, Camille Peters. Slated at reporter, from Yamhill Carlton, Briley Ingram. Slated at Sentinel, from Tillamook, Ryan Mazay. And in alphabetical order at large by first name, from Roseburg, Michaela Carter. From Joseph, Mary Teal. From Pendleton, Riley Demenu. And from Crane, Taylor Baker. That is all, Mr. President.
Fred and the entire nominating committee, thank you for your work that you have done the past 3 days preparing the slate of candidates. We cannot thank you enough for the reaching you have done this week. Please join me in a round of applause for the work done by your 2023 state nominating committee. Candidates, we congratulate you on your achievement so far, and we wish you the best of luck as we continue the process. From the moment you begin speaking, you will be given exactly 2 minutes. At the end of the 2 minutes, the microphone will be shut off. You should stop talking at that time. We will begin with the last at-large candidate and finish with the candidate that is first slated at president. After all the speeches are finished and you have exited the stage, we will open the floor for nominations. You may choose to accept or decline a nomination at any time. Madam Executive Secretary, will you please send out the practice vote?
Mr. President, the practice vote has been sent.
Thank you.
Delegates, I'll check with you in about 45 seconds to see if you all received that email. So we're just going to wait patiently for a moment. Thank you.
While you guys are waiting, you want to hear a riddle? What kind of tree fits in your hand? Okay, you guys didn't have to ruin it that quickly. Gosh. It's okay. When I think of another one, I'll let you know. Okay, here, how about this guessing game? Which state staff can rap the creed? Say it one more time, a little bit louder. Yeah, Lee Letch can rap the creed.
All right, delegates, if you have not received the test email, please stand up. Thank you. Have a seat. All right, if you have not received the email test vote, please stand up and make your way to the Secretary's table. Secretary's table. Thank you.
Disney trivia, anybody? Okay. What is the mom's name in Tangled, the evil one? Oh, yep, right there. I heard it over here first, but I saw a hand over here first.
Mr. President, will you do me a favor? Can you point your microphone up a little bit?
Yep.
Thank you.
Is that a little bit better?
That's a whole lot better.
Awesome. What is Nemo's dad's name? What is Lightning McQueen's catchphrase? Solid. Which of the seven dwarves do I represent most? I figured that one. What is my middle name? No. Oh, who said it over there? Yeah, Graham got it. I gotta think of more questions. Huh? Hold on. I think we're almost done at the secretary table.
More trivia! I love you,
Brother.
Hold on. Madam Secretary, has everybody received the vote?
Everybody has received their votes. If you have not yet submitted, please do so now.
What is my favorite Disney princess? Oh, I heard it over there. What'd you say? Ariel. Eh. If you guys look right up there, my aunt and my mom over there, they're the ones that like made me like love Disney the way I do. And I used to sing like Little Mermaid all the time. Fun fact, I was Prince Eric in my 7th grade middle school play.
Mr. President.
Yes, Madam Executive Secretary.
All delegate votes have been received.
Awesome. Thank you. All right. At this time, we will move into top 10 speeches. We'll start with the last candidate slated at large, moving to the first candidate slated at president. Remember, as soon as you begin speaking, the mic will start, your time will start, and as soon as 2 minutes hits, your mic will be shut off. You may start at any time. Go ahead.
To start, can I please have all of you close your eyes and imagine the most beautiful galaxy? Watch the stars as they all shine differently, radiating their own light that contributes to the brightness of the sky. Now I want you to imagine what would happen if all the stars that felt their light wasn't good enough disappeared. Wow, my imagined sky just got a lot darker. Now I want you to think about a struggle that has dared to imprison your light. I'm sure we've all been there because I know we can all relate. Now open your eyes. For me personally, comparison was my struggle. I remember countless mornings standing in front of my mirror, being so focused on fitting in that I totally lost who I was and didn't realize that my differences empowered me to shine. Now, the truth is, there was nothing wrong with my situation. The problem was with my perspective. Nick Voich believes in the power of positive mindset. A man born without arms or legs, he has definitely had his fair share of struggles, but dares to stand by this statement. If you can't get a miracle, be one. We all know that we can't change our circumstances, but we can change the way we react to them. We can utilize our broken pieces and our differences to shine and help others. Oregon FFA, you are like the stars in the night sky. You bring light into this world. I believe in our impact when we shine together. Oregon FFA, we have recognized our struggles, changed our perspectives. Now let's go use our lights to cultivate an impact.
It's the fourth quarter. My hometown Buckaroos were down by just 1 point. Being the student section leader, I knew I had to do something to move our Buckaroo football team onto the 4A state quarterfinals. I eagerly start searching for my phone and start scrolling. There, I find it. The perfect cheer. I run in front of my student section and yell. Repeat after me, Buckaroos. Pump, pump, pump it up. Pump, pump, pump it up. Pump that bulldog. Spirit up. Right then and there, I had known I had made a huge mistake. How could I, the girl who loves her Buckaroos, say the wrong mascot? Especially since the Bulldogs are our biggest rival school. That's when the booing began. That was truly one of the most embarrassing moments of my life. But something I realized in that moment of pure embarrassment is that I was me. I was the Riley who was outgoing, cheering on her friends, and had a little blonde moment where she said the wrong mascot, but I was me. Oregon FFA, the best advice I have ever been given is you be you. You are the only you, and you must embrace that through your ups and downs. When you question if being you is a good idea, just remember that you would not be sitting in the chairs you are right now in this moment if you hadn't been yourself. Oregon FFA, it is my hope that over this next year, I can help you become the best you you can be.
All right, everyone, shake out your arms and look at your hands. Look at the lines that crisscross your palms, the calluses or the scars. You can put them down now. There are two ways to know someone without speaking. Their eyes, their windows to the soul, and their hands, which reveal how they've lived. Now, in my eyes, the most beautiful hands in the world belong to my dad. Hands that cultivate the land, that have spent years honing their craft. Calloused and strong, they have been my inspiration and support. Now think of your advisor's hands. Do they carry some of these same qualities? Maybe, maybe not. Maybe instead you see quick fingers that help you make last minute edits the night before the competition. Or maybe you see a softness that encourages you to keep going when things get tough. As members of the FFA, we have so many hands pushing for our success. Our advisors, our friends, and each other. Each of the lines in our hands tells our story and the gifts that we have to share. Experience is powerful, and sharing our stories is the key to making deep and meaningful connections. Each member has an impact that creates a crease in the hands of Oregon FFA. What we do matters, and our choices determine the direction of our organization. So I ask you, what will you do with your story? Oregon FFA, I bring my hands and my story to serve you. Thank you.
Oregon FFA, trying new things can be really scary. Whether it's giving a presentation to your class or sending a text to your crush, the fear of trying something new can prevent us from doing anything at all. I remember my first time showing hogs in 4-H. I was scared because I had no idea how to show an animal that was 3 times my weight. So you can imagine taking care of Charlie came with a bit of a learning curve. A sassy Hampshire with a lot of personality. She and I had some trouble getting ready for confirmation because for some reason, Charlie did not want to go to the wash racks. We got all the way to the door until she suddenly froze and immediately sprinted back the way we came. She ran at top speed through the aisles until a man leaning against a panel was directly in her line of travel. She plowed into the man and stepped on both of his feet. Now, getting stepped on by a pig hurts, but this guy was wearing flip-flops. I could hear him screaming in pain as I ran past, yelling, "Sorry," as if that would help. But after 30 minutes of chasing Charlie down, I'm proud to announce that she got 7th in her class out of 8. This fiasco was stressful, but I learned 2 important things. 1, never wear flip-flops in the pig barn. And 2, sometimes fear can lead us to do some pretty crazy things, like in Charlie's case. But facing our fears allows us to grow as people by trying new and exciting things. The more we face our fears, the less scary they become. If Charlie would have faced her fear, she would have found it led her to getting one of her favorite things, a bath. Oregon FFA, let's not be like Charlie. Allow yourself to try new things and know that I'm here to make that journey a little less scary. Thank you.
There is a day that will forever be etched in my mind, February 8th, 2011. February 8th marks the anniversary of a car accident that resulted in the passing of my mom and 8-year-old sister. I was only 5 years old, and suddenly it was just my dad and I. Luckily, I had grandparents and parents of friends who were willing to help lighten the load for him. They would pick me up from school, take me to appointments, and even take me fishing. Thanks, Grandpa. In a time of tragedy like this, it would be easy to lose all hope and fill yourself with hate. Fortunately, my family chose to do the exact opposite of that. You see, my mom and sister were known for their incredible kindness within our community, and because of this, my family decided to start the Acting Kindness Project to carry on their legacy of kindness and compassion. From providing clean, dry clothes to grade school kids, to printing out thousands of stickers every year, my family has made it their mission to encourage kindness. Growing up, this had a huge impact on me. It taught me to see the positive light in a difficult situation and reminded me to be grateful for every second that I have. We all have a limited amount of time to spread positivity, and it doesn't matter what kind of car you drive or how many social media followers you have, because nobody will remember any of that. What they will remember is how you made them feel. Something insignificant, such as holding open a door or giving a small compliment, can leave a lasting, positive impact on those around you. By using our valuable time to spread positivity and promote kindness, we can all make a difference. So Oregon FFA, I'm asking you for the chance to shine my light of positivity while encouraging all of you to act in kindness. Thank you.
Have you ever found yourself struggling to place one foot in front of the other, fighting to find time to take a breath? In the midst of a landslide, you prepare yourself for the fall rather than fight to continue the climb. Mountains are just the walls of the horizon with ledges and cliffs that spike fear and uncertainty. Many of us choose to travel around the mountain once faced with adversity, losing sight of the opportunity to feel the thrill of the summit. Oregon FFA, what mountains have you had to climb recently? The smell of sunscreen and the taste of red Gatorade takes me back to the circle. As the sunlight lights up the strike zone, I brace myself for the next pitch. I quickly change my grip on the ball when suddenly I feel an intense tug in my shoulder and pain radiates throughout my arm. This was just the beginning of my climb. Softball had become my home, and the thought of losing the one thing I felt most confident in over an injury was discouraging. I was stuck on the ledge of this mountain, and the only way to get around was by saying two words that quickly became like a second language to me. I can't. That was up until I took a moment to reflect back on Little League. You are not able to yet. This was a phrase my coach would say to me when there was any sign of doubt amongst us. After repeating this to myself just a couple of times, I was ready to face every cliff full of fear and uncertainty that kept me from reaching my summit and gaining my confidence back. Oregon FFA, let's unite on our journeys up the mountain this year. United, we can all feel the thrill of the summit.
Oregon FFA, what do you keep in the pockets of your blue jacket? Maybe you like to have a few spare pencils on hand or a pin you won during your favorite CDE. When I reach into my jacket pockets, I'm met with a few objects. My favorite purple pen, a candy wrapper or two, and a happy gram from my first leadership camp. It's seen better days and the edges are torn from being unfolded so many times. While it's over 3 years old, it hasn't lost its meaning. I showed up to my first leadership camp a day late, and after walking into a workshop, my mind was racing. I took one look around the room, and I knew nobody. I felt like it was too late for me to join in. But after that first day, I received a note from a district officer. It read, "I'm so glad you were here this weekend. I loved getting to know you." We've all had those moments, right? When we feel like we're just a little late to the party. But after reading the note, my confidence was boosted, and it showed me that the words we use have the chance to motivate others. While each happy gram you get might look and sound a little different, they all have one common goal: to encourage others. When you think about it, FFA members are sort of like a happy gram. We might all come from different towns and have a variety of passions and perspectives we hope to share, but we are all working towards one common goal. The goal is to impact others with our unique voices and to push each other to grow into active leaders, to do better so that we can be better. Oregon FFA, this next year, let's write a happy gram together with a message that ignites and inspires you and tuck it into our jacket pockets. Whether we're traveling to a leadership camp or a classroom visit, let's take this message that empowers us and share it with each other wherever we go. Thank you.
Funny, kind, loving, encouraging. These are all adjectives that I constantly hear describing FFA members. But something I don't hear as often is the word loud. Now, some of you might think that isn't a good thing, to be called loud. But I believe it's one of the best adjectives we could ever be described as. To be loud is to be firm and confident in your beliefs. To be loud is to stand up for yourself and your communities. Being loud is about doing the things that amplify you, whether that be showing livestock, volunteering in your communities, or something in between. But being loud isn't always so easy. It took me many parent-teacher conferences telling my parents I was too loud, trips to the office, and a passion for me to truly understand the difference between loud and disruptive. Members of my community saw my potential and handed me a microphone when it was time to be loud. I became passionate about the agricultural issues in my community and my ability to convey those problems. And Oregon FFA, I see your potential. I know you can be loud, and I want you to be loud. Serving this association would be a blessing, and the word loud doesn't have to be one that describes someone like elementary school Alicia. Let's make it an adjective that describes FFA members. So Oregon FFA, do me, you, and this community a favor. Use the microphones this organization offers us and the voices God has given us to be loud.
And on the eighth day, God looked down on his planned paradise, said, I need a caretaker. So God made a farmer. Most of us have heard Paul Harvey's famous So God Made a Farmer speech. But did you know that there's a new counterpart to this iconic speech? I like to call it So God Made an FFA Member. And it goes like this. God said, I need someone willing enough to get at the crack of dawn, put on their official dress, chug an energy drink, and meet their advisor for a day of travel and competition. Someone working to win, but can lose humbly. So God made an FFA member. He said, I need someone who can raise animals for the county fair, be trusted to drive combine during harvest season, fix broken machinery, doctor livestock, weld clean lines, learn from local ag businesses, perform research projects, and do it all enthusiastically. So God made an FFA member. God said, I need someone who can be a voice for agriculture, an advocate for the things that they love, someone willing to have conversations because they know when they wear this blue jacket, they have a unique chance to be listened to. He needed someone that cares about their future impact. So God made an FFA member. When God made Oregon FFA members, he made each one with a purpose. Whether your purpose is stewarding Oregon's agriculture industry, advocating for the things that you love, or maybe being the advisor that helps members progress, you are vital to this organization's future. My hope, if I'm a state officer, is to walk alongside you as you discover your purpose. Because maybe that's why God made this FFA member. Thank you.
I'm JL Cruikshank from the Bend FFA chapter. There I am, running across the field in my green Bend Sounders jersey. Through the roar of the crowd, I hear my second grade soccer league teammates cheering me on. This is my shot. So with all the power I have in my small 7-year-old body, I take it. I just scored my first goal. Yeah. Fast forward 10 minutes. The teams are tied, and I have another clear shot. Feeling a little bit more confident, I go straight for the kick. A moment later, I'm laying on the ground, looking up at my teammates, laughing at me, because this time, I had tripped over the ball. How often do we find ourselves in situations like these? Feeling on top of the world one moment, and laying on our back in pain the next. This game was quite the roller coaster for me. I think we can all agree that our Blue Jacket stories are similarly a big roller coaster adventure. The excitement of dance parties or making a new friend to the pain of not receiving that banner or office we wanted. But our value and purpose doesn't change because of how we place in a contest. These moments need to develop us instead of define us. We need to stop letting the high moments go to our head and the low moments go to our heart. Because who we become is and always will be more important than what we accomplish. Oregon FFA, in the next hour, I could have a high or a low moment. But no matter what, I want to become a servant leader who loves God and the people around me. And I only have one question for you. Who can we become together?
Good job, everyone. You guys did an amazing job. At this time, you may all take your seats back on the floor. Jen, I'll take the microphone. Should I keep Kylie and JL? Kylie and JL, will you please stay up here? Slated at president is JL Cruikshank and Kylie Temple. Are there any further nominations? Chair calls on Roseburg.
Andy Robison of the Roseburg FFA chapter. I nominate Camille Peters for president.
Does the candidate accept or decline this nomination?
The candidate respectfully declines.
Thank you. Are there any further nominations? The chair calls on Henley.
Ryan Orr Henley. I nominate Alicia Venegas for president.
Does the candidate accept or decline?
The candidate respectfully declines.
Thank you. Are there any further nominations? Saniam Christian.
Kyle Page of the Saniam Christian FFA chapter. I nominate Briley Inglam of the Yamhill chapter for president.
Does the candidate accept or decline?
The candidate respectfully declines.
Thank you. Are there any further nominations? Nominations are now closed and will now proceed to vote. Madam Executive Secretary, will you please send out the vote?
Good morning, delegates and guests. Who's ready for a talent show? I said, who's ready for a talent show? Alrighty. Our first act is no stranger to the stage. In fourth grade, she participated in her talent show, dancing in a group called the Uptown Funky Girls. She'll be singing Dark Horse in the Cherry Tree by KT Tunstall. Let's welcome to the stage Megan Sharp of the Amity FFA chapter.
But my heart knows it better than I know myself, so I'm gonna let it do all the talking. I came across a place in the middle of nowhere with a big black horse and a cherry tree. I felt a little fear upon my back. I said, don't look back, just keep on walking. The big black horse, it looked this way. It said, hey little lady, will you marry me? But I said, no, 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 no. I said, no, no, you're not the one for me. No, 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 no. I said, no, no, you're not the one for me. And my heart hit a problem in the early hours, so it stopped it dead for a bit or two. But I cut some cord and I shouldn't have done that, and it won't forgive me after all these years. Yeah. So I sent it to a place in the middle of nowhere with a big black horse and a cherry tree. Now it won't come back cause it's oh so happy, and now I got a hope for the world to see. Yeah. And it said no, 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 no. It said no, no, you're not the one for me. No, 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 no. It said no, no, you're not the one for me. Can't quite get there cause my heart's forsaking me, yeah, yeah. Big black horse and a cherry tree. I can't quite get there cause my heart's forsaking me. Thank you.
Slated now at Vice President is Kylie Temple from the Hermiston FFA chapter. Are there any further nominations? Chair calls on Henley.
Ethan Roloffs from the Henley chapter, and I nominate Alicia Venegas for Vice
President. Is there a second? Alicia. Madras seconds. Does the candidate accept or decline the nomination?
The candidate respectfully declines.
Thank you. Are there any further nominations? Chair calls on Elkton.
Melica Bile from the Elkton FFA chapter, and I nominate Michaela for Vice President.
Is there a second? Jordan Valley seconds. Does the candidate accept or decline?
The candidate respectfully declines.
Thank you. Are there any further nominations? Chair calls on Hillsborough.
Kyle Brandt from Hillsborough, and I nominate Ryan Mazay for Vice President.
Tillamook seconds. Does the candidate accept or decline?
The candidate respectfully declines.
Thank you. Are there any further nominations? We turn it a little bit. Perfect. Glide.
Macy Mornerich from Glide, and I nominate Camille Peters from Elkton.
Is there a second? Sandy seconds. Does the candidate accept or decline?
The candidate accepts.
Are there any further nominations? The chair calls on Illinois Valley.
Aiden Gilkey from the Illinois Valley FFA chapter. I nominate Riley Demenu from
Pelican. Is there a second? Cook County seconds. Does the candidate accept or decline?
The candidate respectfully declines.
Thank you. Are there any further nominations? Nominations are now closed. Madam Executive Secretary, will you please send out the vote?
Members and valued guests, we're thankful that you're here observing this voting process. If you could do us a favor, if you have a phone and you are not a delegate, can you pull your phone out and temporarily disable your Wi-Fi? Just turn your Wi-Fi off for us for a little while you're in the building, and it'll help make sure that our voting process goes off without a hitch. Thanks for your help.
Alrighty, our next act is a true cowboy. He loves to show cattle, run, and ride horses. He'll be performing Feathered Indians by Tile Chillers. Please welcome Rhett Smith from the Cambie FFA chapter.
Mm-hmm.
that there are little feathered Indians where we tossed through the night. If I'd known she was a legend, then I wouldn't have came stoned to the house of such an angel, too messed up to get back home. Ain't anybody told you that them things are bad for you? I said many folks have warned me, and there's been several people try, but until now there ain't been nothing that I couldn't leave behind. Hold me close, my dear, sing your way. Count on you to be there when the bullets fly. I'd run across the river just to hold you tonight. Well, my heart is sweating bullets from the circles it has raised, like a little feathered Indian calling out the clouds for rain. I go running through the thicket, I go careless through the thorn, just to hold her for a minute, though it leave me wanting more. Hold me close, my dear, sing your whispering song softly in my. River just to hold you tonight.
Thank you.
Slated as secretary, Alicia Venegas. Are there any further nominations? Chair calls on Glide.
Eliora Dunavant of the Glide FFA chapter, I nominate Camille Peters for president.
Is there a second? Sherman County seconds. Does the candidate accept or decline the nomination?
The candidate accepts.
Are there any further nominations? Chair calls on Harper.
Bennett Johnson of the Harper FFA chapter, I nominate Taylor Baker for the position of secretary.
Is there a second? Northlake seconds. Does the candidate accept or decline?
The candidate respectfully declines.
Thank you. Are there any further nominations? Chair calls on Joseph.
Kane Johnson from the Joseph FFA chapter. I nominate Mary Teal for secretary.
Is there a second? Union seconds. Does the candidate accept or decline?
The candidate accepts.
Are there any further nominations? Chair calls on Hillsborough.
Allison Hyman from Hillsborough. I nominate Ryan Mays for secretary.
Is there a second? Cook County seconds. Does the candidate accept or decline the nomination?
The candidate accepts.
Are there any further nominations? Chair calls on Pendleton.
Faith Olson from the Pendleton FFA chapter, and I nominate Riley Demenu.
Lakeview seconds. Does the candidate accept or decline?
The candidate accepts.
Are there any further nominations? Chair calls on Roseburg.
Savannah Kempton from Roseburg, and I nominate Michaela Carter.
Is there a second? Lakeview seconds. Does the candidate accept or decline?
The candidate accepts.
Are there any further nominations? Nominations are now closed. We will now proceed to vote. Madam Executive Secretary, will you please send the vote?
Alrighty, our next performer's been playing his good old guitar for 6 years now. He'll be performing The Auctioneer by Leroy Van Dyke. Please welcome Caleb Kearns of the North Battle FFA chapter.
$25 bidder now, $30, $30, will you give me $30, make it $30, bidder mama, $30, will you give me $30, you'd have better $30 bid. $30 bidder now, $35, will you give me $30, make it $35, who would have bidded at a $35 bid. As time went on, he did his best, and all could see he didn't jest, he practiced calling bids both night and day. His papa find him behind the barn, just working up an awful storm. He tried to imitate the auctioneer.
Then his pap said, son, we just can't stand to have a mediocre man sell things at auction using our good name. I'll send you off to auction school, then you'll be nobody's fool. You can take your place among the best. $35 bidder now, $40 for the willing, give me $40, make it $40, bid him on a $40, willing, give me $40, you the bid a $40 bid. $40 bidder now, $45, willing, give me $40, right? $45, bid a $45, who would have bid it at a $45 bid? So from that boy who went to school, there grew a man who played it cool. He came back home a full-fledged auctioneer. And the people came from miles around just to hear him make that rhythmic sound that filled their hearts with such a happy cheer. His fame spread out from shore to shore, he had all he could do and more. Had to buy a plane to get around. Now he's the tops in all the land, let's pause and give that man a hand. He's the best of all the auctioneers. $45 bidder now, $50, $50, will he give me $50, make a $50, bid a dollar, $50, will he give me $50, who would have bid a $50 bid? $50 bidder now, $55, will he give me $50, make a $50, buy that $50, $55, sold that hog for $50 bid.
Have a runoff. Candidates, when I call your name, please come up onto the stage. In alphabetical order, Alicia Venegas. Camille Peters. And Ryan Mazet. Madam Executive Secretary, will you please send the vote? We have another runoff. Listen, you guys are the ones voting. All right, in alphabetical order, Alicia Venegas. And Ryan Mize. Madam Executive Secretary, will you please send out the new vote?
Members and valued guests, we're thankful that you're here and able to participate and observe in our voting process, but we ask that you will remain silent while our delegates are voting. Thank you very much for your cooperation. Treasurer is Camille Peters. And also Alicia Venegas. Are there any further nominations? Chair calls on Camus Valley.
Julie Amos from the Camus Valley FFA chapter. I nominate Michaela Carter for treasurer.
Is there a second? Harrisburg, seconds. Does the candidate accept or decline?
The candidate accepts.
Are there any further nominations? Union.
Livy Sturm from the Union FFA chapter, and I nominate Mary Teal.
Is there a second? Northlake, seconds. Does the candidate accept or decline?
The candidate accepts.
Are there any further nominations? Chair calls on Dufer.
I'm Kaylee Wiles from the Dufer FFA chapter, and I nominate Briley Ingram for treasurer.
Is there a second? Lakeview seconds. Does the candidate accept or decline?
The candidate accepts.
Are there any further nominations? Chair calls on Burns.
Cassidy Maupin from the Burns chapter, I nominate Taylor Baker for treasurer.
Is there a second? Rainier seconds. Does the candidate accept or decline?
The candidate accepts.
Are there any further nominations? Nominations are now closed. Madam Secretary, will you please send out the vote?
Alrighty, our next two performers have a pretty good head of hair. Not as good as mine, but still pretty good. They will be performing Doing This by Luke Combs. Please help me welcome Wyatt Bunch and Ben Smith of the Sherwood FFA chapter.
Guitar and an old bar stool. 'Cause I'd have a Friday night crowd in the palm of my hand. Couple brown liquor, couple buddies in a band. Singing them same damn songs like I am now. I'd be feeling on fire on a hardwood stage. Bright lights like lightning running through my veins. At the Grand Ole Opry or showing some no-name town. Still be doing this if I wasn't doing this. I'd still be the same guy they knew back in the day, who was burning CDs just to give them away, paying his dues. If I wasn't doing this. 5 deep in a van, head full of steam. Hot on the hills, my neon dreams, baby, coming true. Living this life, just like I was born to do. 'Cause I'd have a Friday night crowd in the palm of my hand. Couple brown liquor, couple buddies in a band. Singing them same damn songs like I am now. I'd be feeling on fire on a hardwood stage. Bright lights like lightning running through my veins. At the Grand Ole Opry or showing some no-name town. Still be doing this if I wasn't doing this. It ain't about the fame, it ain't about the fortune, it ain't about the name, it ain't about the glory. I guess I'm saying it's always been about having a Friday night crowd in the palm of my hand. Couple brown liquor, couple buddies in a band. Singing them same damn songs like I am now. I'd be feeling on fire on a hardwood stage. Bright lights like lightning running through my veins. At the grand
where'd you go to school and what would you do if you weren't doing this?
We have a runoff. In alphabetical order. Alicia Venegas. And Camille Peters. Madam Executive Secretary, will you please send out the vote?
Thank you.
now slated at reporter is Alicia Venegas. And Briley Ingram. Are there any further nominations? Chair calls on Oakland.
I'm Ethan Webb from the Oakland FFA chapter, and I nominate Michaela Carter for treasurer, for reporter.
Elkton seconds. Does the candidate accept or decline?
The candidate accepts.
Are there any further nominations? Chair calls on Nyssa.
I'm Spencer Romans from the Nyssa chapter, and I nominate Taylor Baker for reporter.
Is there a second? Rainier seconds. Does the candidate accept or decline?
The candidate accepts.
Are there any further nominations? Chair calls on Joseph.
I'm Kane Johnson from the Joseph FFA chapter, and I nominate Mary Teal.
Is there a second? Imbler seconds. Does the candidate accept or decline?
The candidate accepts.
Are there any further nominations? Chair calls on Staten.
I'm Jacob Mickish from the Staten FFA chapter, and I nominate Riley Demenu for reporter.
Dallas seconds. Is there, or does the candidate accept or decline?
The candidate accepts.
Nominations are now closed. Madam Executive Secretary, will you please send the vote?
Members and valued guests, thank you again for your cooperation and being silent during our voting process. Also, those of you that have just come into the room, if you'll do us a favor, you can help us out with our voting process by grabbing your phone and disabling your Wi-Fi temporarily while you are in this room. If you can, please grab your phone and temporarily disable your Wi-Fi. It will help us have a more solid voting experience. Thank you.
You know what they say, best for last. She loves to dance and try new things, singing Over the Rainbow. Please help me welcome Michaela Nichols of the Adrian FFA chapter.
You guys are killing yourselves. You guys are voting. We have a runoff in alphabetical order. Alicia Venegas. And Mary Teal. Madam Executive Secretary, will you please send the new vote? All right. Now slated at Sentinel is Briley Ingram. Are there any further nominations? Chair calls on North Clackamas.
I'm Brianna Lynch from North Clackamas, and we nominate Mary Thiel from Joseph.
Is there a second? Sandy seconds. Does the candidate accept or decline?
The candidate accepts.
Are there any further nominations? Chair calls on Mohawk.
I'm Abrianna Roberts from the Mohawk FFA chapter, and we nominate Michaela Carter.
So second, Crook County seconds. Does the candidate accept or decline?
The candidate accepts.
Are there any further nominations? Chair calls on Crane.
I'm Piper Thompson from the Crane FFA chapter, and I nominate Taylor Baker for Sentinel.
Is there any seconds? Hermiston prospect, or Hermiston seconds. Does the candidate accept or decline?
The candidate accepts.
Are there any further nominations? Chair calls on Nyssa.
I am Spencer Romans from the NISA FFA chapter, and I nominate Riley Demenu.
So second, Stanfield seconds. Does the candidate accept or decline?
The candidate accepts.
Nominations are now closed. Madam Executive Secretary, will you please send the vote?
Members and guests, thank you again for your cooperation, remaining silent during our voting process. And if you have a cell phone and can shut off your Wi-Fi, that would be fantastic. We really appreciate your cooperation. Thank you.
We will now have talent awards. Give me 1 second. All right, guys, we're waiting for our talent people to get prepped, but got a joke for you. A fish, okay, it's a very fancy fish, looks very pretty, walks into a restaurant. What is the order?
Water.
Listen, it's not a good joke. My mom says it all the time, and she thinks it's hilarious. Shout out to my mom, Jennifer Hills, everybody. All right, now we will have our talent results. In fourth place, from Canby, Rhett Smith.
In third place, from North Powder, Caleb Kearns. In second place, from Sherwood, Ben Smith and Wyatt Bunch. And in first, from Amity, Megan Scharf. Let's give one last round of applause for all of our talents. Now we have a runoff. Riley Ingram. And Mary Teal. Will the secretary table please send the new vote?
Members and guests will ask again that you please remain silent during the voting and tabulation process. We appreciate that you're here. Thank you.
FFA, your 2023-2024
Oregon FFA State Sentinel is, from Joseph, Mary Teal.
Congratulations to the new team, and thank you, delegates. We will now adjourn this delegate session. We look forward to seeing you right back here at 12 for the final session of the 95th Oregon FFA State Convention.